A very good morning to all the students of PUC first year arts, science and commerce. I am Muhammad Ghulam Rabbani from Department of English, working at Nehru Arts, Science and Commerce College, Kanchigiri, Hubli. Dear students, today, without taking much of your time, I would like to start a topic by name Babar Ali. So the title is Babar Ali. Chapter number 6 and subtitle is World's Youngest Headmaster, Making Remarkable Changes in India. So he is the world's youngest headmaster, making remarkable changes in India. It is written by Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma. My dear students, this story is very, very inspiring, very, very motivational, and I hope that everybody will get inspiration after listening this class. My dear students, Babar Ali, at the mere age of 16, became the youngest headmaster of the world. Just imagine. And there would be queries in your minds, doubts in your mind, that at the mere age of 16, how a person or a boy can become the youngest headmaster. My dear students, this is a real story. It is not a fictional. It is not a fictional story. Let me tell you. It is the real story. It happened in Murshidabad in West Bengal. And later on you will come to know that it is not an old story. It is the story of 2011. And still the boy is headmaster of his school, Anand Shiksha Niketan. So when you learn about Babar Ali, you will be surprised, you will be amazed and mesmerized, you will be attracted towards Babar Ali's efforts, Babar Ali's works, Babar Ali's achievements. My dear students, let me also inform you that Babar Ali was not from a rich family. He was from a very poor family, and he was the only person or only boy from his village, Bhaktapur village. Later on you will come to know. He was the only lucky soul or lucky person or lucky boy who completed his school, or who completed his school education. He enrolled in college later on. He was the only person from his village, and he wanted to educate all the poor children. When he saw the plight of the children, when he saw that small children, instead of going to school, they are working under the sunshine. Girl children, they are working as a maid servant, cleaning and washing the vessels and the clothes. He could not tolerate this. He wanted to contribute something for the society. He wanted to improve the society, the village. And let me tell you, my dear students, if society is developed, village will be developed. If villages will be developed, then the cities and towns will be developed. When the cities and towns will be developed, the state will be developed, the province will be developed, and when the state will be developed, the country will be developed. And it was the intention of Babar Ali to develop the society, to develop his village, and to develop the careers of poor children. My dear students, as I told you in my previous class, that it is a tradition of English teacher that he or she starts his class by giving the introduction of the writer or the author or the poet according to the genre of literature, according to the forms of literature. If it is poetry, poet or poetess. If it is prose form of literature like drama, novel, prose or essays, then it is about author or writer, we can see, or novelist or dramatist, we can see, or prose writer, we can see, essayist, we can see, or simply we can say writer. So my dear students, who is the writer? Writer is Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma. You must know about Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma, and even you have to write a few sentences about the writer as well while you are going to write a question relating to 4 marks or descriptive answer. So you have to write few sentences about the author also. One thing I would like to share with you people, that you are in PUC first year or in second year, what would be the pattern of writing 4 marks questions? That you should not write about introduction, then about the author, and summary or content, then conclusion. It is a pattern of writing answer who are in degree or in graduation. So you are in PUC first year or in second year also, the what would be the pattern of writing 4 marks questions? That you have to start with a writer. For example, Babar Ali is written by Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma, and about Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma you have to write few sentences. She's a great writer. She contributed a lot for the English literature. She was journalist also, like this. Then you have to start according to the question. Or some students who are average or below average, and they are unable to write because they are from vernacular mediums. They are from Urdu medium, Kannada medium. Then what you have to do, that you just by heart the summary, or to go around 1 page or 1.5 page or 1 page, and write what is called the summary. Instead of 4 marks, 3 marks will be given, or 2.5 marks at least will be given to you people. So this is the method, this is the technique of writing in the examination. My dear students, now let me start introducing the writer. The writer is Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma. So who is Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma? On the screen you can see about the writer, and Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma is the associate creative editor of Youth Leader India. So she was the associate creative editor of Youth Leader India, the Indian India chapter of Youth Leader magazine. She was also the leader of India chapter of Youth. She is a member of Dynamic. She is also a member of Dynamic Action Oriented Online Magazine, Action Oriented Online Magazine Network, focusing on groundbreaking positive change initiatives, portraits, tools, and more. So in short, we can say that she is a writer.
she is a leader, she is editor, and she is a multi-talented person who contributed for the literature, English literature, and for magazine also. Now, let me start the topic. Now come to page number 45, my dear students. And you, whenever you listen this, you open the book, turn the page number, then start reading or listening. At the same time, you can read the sentences and you will be able to understand the story. My dear students, pre-reading activity. See there on the top of the page. Do you know of people who have brought about a transformation? Transformation means change in the lives of their fellow beings. So, do you know of people? There are certain people who have transformed in the lives of their fellow beings, who have brought the changes in the lives of many people. There are great examples. There are many great examples also. Now discuss with your friends, my dear students. You discuss with your friends, and you will come to know that there are certain people who dedicated their lives for the development of others, for the elevation of others, and for the making of careers of others. So let me start here. Babar Ali must be the youngest headmaster in the world. The writers Samarpita Mukherjee Sharma says, Babar Ali must be the youngest headmaster in the world. Do you know why? Later on you will come to know, because he is very, very young. He is a teenager and he became the youngest headmaster in the world, as he is only 16. Why? Because he is only 16. At the age of 16, he became the youngest headmaster. My dear students, just imagine that at the age of 16, the boys or girls, they are going to school, they are playing and wasting their time, they are playing on the grounds, playing football, cricket, they are chatting, wasting their times after coming of their schools. But this great soul, this great boy, at the mere age of, at the 16, he became the youngest headmaster of the world. You just imagine about his achievements. My dear students, this is very, very inspiring story. This is very, very motivational story. And you will come to know about him. And definitely, I am damn sure that you will be inspired that he is a teenager who is in charge of teaching hundreds of students in his family's backyard. Just imagine, he is a teenager who is in charge of teaching hundreds of students. Hundreds of students. Later on you will come to know that how many students were there in his school, and there were around 800 students. Later on you will come to know. Here it is mentioned that he is taking the charge of teaching hundreds of students in his family's backyard. Just imagine, in his family's backyard only. Backside of his family's house, he used to gather, he used to assemble his students and teaching hundreds of students from his what is called village. So where he runs classes for poor children from his village, he used to run his classes. Where he used to run his classes? In his family's backyard. And how many students were there? Around 800 students. Later on you will come to know. And he used to gather the students from his village because they were not going to school. That's why he wanted to teach them the basic rights. He wanted to show them the right path, and he wanted to enlighten their minds so that they will come to know what is good, what is bad, what is right, what is wrong, what is called Indian Constitution, what are the rights, basic rights are given, fundamental rights are given. At least the students will come to know, at least the what is called villagers will come to know, at least the children will come to know, because they did not know anything. So without education, what is called, the mind won't be illuminated, mind can't be enlightened, and people will be in darkness. They won't know anything what is happening around the world. With this intention, with this purpose, Baba Ali wanted to teach hundreds of students, and without taking money, it was free of cost. My dear students, let me continue here. The history of this young man from Murshidabad in West Bengal is a remarkable tale of the desire. Tale means T-A-L-E, tale means story, moral story. Tale of the desires to learn amid the direst poverty. So this young man from Murshidabad in West Bengal is a remarkable tale. It is a wonderful story of the young man and who was in desire to learn amid the direst poverty. Though he was in direst poverty, he was in terrible poverty, he was in awful poverty, yet he wanted to teach hundreds of students without taking even a single paisa. Just imagine, it was a good intention, it was a beautiful intention, it was a good purpose of this young man to educate the young children. Our Bangladesh-based YL volunteer Tanvir would like to introduce you to this extraordinary change maker. So our Bangladesh-based YL volunteer, there is a volunteer, what is called, he was from Bangladesh-based, and his name was Tanvir. Would like to introduce you to this extraordinary change maker, Tanvir from Bangladesh. He is to visit nearby countries or areas to, what is called, to know about the education or education system. So this man, Tanvir, from Bangladesh or Bangladesh based, he came to, what is called, India, went to Murshidabad. He came to know about Babar Ali. When he came to know about Babar Ali, he personally visited, physically visited Babar Ali's school. He took interview also, and now he would like to introduce this extraordinary change maker. Who is the extraordinary change maker? He is none other than Babar Ali. He is none other than Babar Ali. Now, who is going to introduce about Babar Ali? That is Tanvir, who was Bangladesh-based YL volunteer. Next, turn page number, what is called, 46. Now, page number 46. Babar Ali, what is the routine of Babar Ali? Babar Ali wakes up every morning at 7 and starts his day by doing some household chores. Just imagine about Babar Ali and his works. This young boy, he used to wake up at 7 a.m. and starts his day by doing some household chores. He used to start his day by doing some household chores. Chores means small works he used to do. Then he takes an auto rickshaw first and later walks 5 kilometers to the Kasim Bazar Rajgovind Sundari Vidyapeeth. So first he used to take auto rickshaw. After auto rickshaw, he used to walk 5 kilometers. Then he was going to his school, and that is, he used to go to his college, Kasim Bazar Rajgovind Sundari Vidyapeeth. What was the name of his college? Kasim Bazar Rajgovind Sundari Vidyapeeth, or institution where he used to read. So what is the name of the institution? That is Kasim Bazar Rajgovind Sundari Vidyapeeth, where he is a class 12 student. Where he was a class 12 students, and Babar is the thin and gangly boy. So what is the features of Babar Ali? Babar Ali was a gangly, thin and gangly boy. Gangly means tall, looking awkward. He was not looking handsome. Handsome is what handsome does. This is a great proverb. Handsome is what handsome does. So you should not look the feature of the person. Beauty or handsomeness of the person or physical strength of the man. The real strength is mental strength. So if you are knowledgeable, you can do anything in this world. See here, this man, this young boy who used to walk 5 kilometers every day, then he was reaching, R-E-A-C-H-I-N-G, reaching. Reach means to go. Then he was going there in his institution where he was a class 12 student. Babar is the thin and gangly boy. He was a thin and very, very awkward boy, tall boy who sits in the middle of the front row. He used to sit in the middle of the front row. He used to occupy what is called the front of the middle row. And studious, smart and austere. How he was? He was studious, very, very studious. Studious means the person who studies very hard. So he was studious. He was very, very, very smart. He was very clever. He was sharp and he was intelligent and austere. A-U-S-T-E-R-E, austere. Austere means well-disciplined boy. He was severe, disciplined boy. Well-disciplined boy in his blue and white uniform. So there was a uniform also. What was the color of uniform? That blue and white. Blue and white. Babar is a model student. So Babar was a model student for others. He was an ideal student for other students. He was an ideal student for other students because he was having all the qualities of an ideal student, of a model student. He is also the first member of his family to get a proper education. So he is also the first member of his family to get a proper education. He was the first member from his family to get a proper education. The rest of the members of the family, they were not given education because of the economical condition of Babar Ali's father. Next, in school he is an ideal student. Already I told you people, in school he was an ideal student. Even teachers used to respect him because of his hard working, because of his achievements. So he was an ideal student for others. He was an example for other students. But it is what he does after his school hours that intrigues the entire world. So it is what he does after his school hours that intrigues. Intrigues means that creates an interest to the entire world, to the whole world. This boy after the school, what he used to do, that is interesting for the whole world. Because after the school, my dear students, he was not wasting his time. He was not going to playground, to play football, to play cricket, to play any other sports. Instead of that, he was giving his time for the development of the poor children. He was going to his family's backyard where he was running classes for the poor students. He was teaching them. So when every other teenager goes running off to the playground and gets busy with football, cricket and other sports, Babar makes his way to an afternoon school where he is the headmaster of a school of 800 students. Already I told you people that when every other teenager, So teenage starts from 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So teenage starts from 13 and ends in 19. So he was 16. So he was also teenager. So unlike other teenagers, they used to go to playground. They were playing football, cricket and other sports. But Babar Ali was not going to, Babar Ali was not going to playground to play cricket, football, hockey or other sports. Instead of going to playground, he used to go to his family's backyard where he was the headmaster of a school of 800 students. So my dear students, in your next class,
I will teach people about Babarli's school and what was the condition of Babarli's school. Under the open sky he used to teach, and without having infrastructure, without having stools, without having benches, chairs. There was a small room, and under the open sky he was teaching 800 students. He was managing 800 students, and everybody used to listen his class, because he was teaching in such a way that he was imparting quality education, he was giving a quality education. That's why everybody used to listen. So my dear students, as you know that if the video class or if the class will be too much, then it will be very difficult to upload on YouTube channel. That's why let me stop for the day here. I will continue to the next class. Have a blessed day and work hard. He is an example. If Babarli can become the youngest headmaster at the age of 16, why you cannot become? You believe in yourself and work hard. One day you will be rewarded, and even your father, your parents will be very much proud of you. So let me stop the class, and I will continue to the next class. Have a blessed day. Thank you very much.